Hamley thumps it out to the wing. Jones was a bit of a post for Bell Chambers to fly. Neil to Walters. Sard's going to keep him honest here. Zaharakis, and suddenly it's Essendon through Langford. Beautiful low ball inside 50, and this time, I suspect, only played 9 games this year, averaging 1.2 goals per game. But we know when he's hot, he's a very damaging player, and he has an early goal on the board. And the defence have the resources, but again, they
sloppy handles early from the Bombers.
It's a bit just off their best. Can't tip him when he takes the mark. Follow up was solid enough. And here's McKernan on the turn. Again, it's Bagley, the focus of the kick at the top of the square. It's going to sit on the line for him. Yep. The high kick, and now the high fives. Overwhelm them this time with numbers. Hill. Hyder full forward. Oh, there's McKernan. That's the way he can impact the contest.
Coming in late for Sean Darcy.
Bell Chambers to the front. McDonald, Tip and Woody claimed immediately. Just fractionally high by Tommy Sheridan. That's when fans think it's about time. McNeice cutting through the wing. Spearing a low ball for Brown. Got Bagley in the square, Fantasia.
Stay on. That's right, he's following him.
And that's a big ball right to the line. Oh, underrepresented on the line, Fremantle, and that's a goal.
Not thrilled that things aren't going their way.
Yeah, so far I think they're expressing it to the umpires, but
that can change.
That can change, yeah, it can change. Fantasia! That can get the Bomber fans up and about.
Shouldn't underestimate how good that man has been, the one just getting up with the ball, Bailey Banfield. He's had 13 possessions and 4 clearances, keeping Merrick to 10 and 2.
A curling ball from Smith. Hamling had that covered. Langford didn't get quite the run of the ball. Great tackle from McDonald, Tip and Woody.
Good decision. Good decision.
That's the threat he poses.
He just threw the arms open. He can complain all he likes, Nathan Wilson, but he threw the arms open as soon as he was tackled.
So David Zaharakis, he made his debut back in round 2, 2009, and that was against Fremantle. He's been a fine player, and he kicks a critical goal. Made the adjustment.
Clever kick,
wasn't it? To Banfield, ignored the forward handball option, instead just chipping for Walters, who relaxed. And you can't do that when Sard's around. The swoop and the handball to Parrish, and Bagley's clear at half forward. Orazio's back in the square. Bagley, and here he comes up at the footy. That was smart from all coming. Kicked 5 lots of 4 goals last year, just the 1 this year, as we know. Injury has really affected his season. But he's back in the team, and he's nailing goals like that that matter, and the Bombers are in front.
You'd expect Myers to finish that on his left foot. He's usually pretty handy.
High ball Ryan. McCarthy gets a run at this, but just hasn't got his timing quite right. Goddard feeding Zaharakis. Damaging. Once again, he finds Mitch Brown tucked up against the line.
It's an important player, Matty Tabin, up for that Fremantle forward line.
Brown. There's a shot at it. And a mighty shot it is. Couple of goals for Mitch Brown. Mitch Brown, another who started in defence in the season. Now, opportunity. Chera comes flying through. Neil overrun. Langford just couldn't claim him completely. Myers, one more give. Fantasia off the left. And the Bombers storming back. 4 goals. Can't squeeze his way out of there. Penalised. Neil just takes it instantly. Sends it forward. And that's a beautifully judged mark from deep.
The other thing that's changed for the Bombers.
Surprise, isn't it, really? Such a prolific ball winner. 36 disposals last week. Kick to half forward. Merritt in the air and on the ground. Banfield had him covered, but he just lingered a fraction too long.
Straight to it.
It's so hard, as we know, for players sometimes. to realise if the guy you're tackling has released the ball or not. Saad is able to lay it off. That sort of stuff deserves a goal. And Smith salutes.
Hurley, Goddard, Bell Chambers, they're just banking on it coming here.
And that would have been a Hurley mark, but Cox did well. Got some interference on it. Now Myers just slipped out of there. Smith likewise. Merritt tried to get it forward. Matera's been in plenty of late. Can they break even at least here? They can. Sutcliffe, Walters. Oh, look at that flash from Merritt. Having a big say now. And down the line, he finds Brown. Hooker leads back at the top of the square.
See, a lot of those behinds are in very, very kickable areas, aren't they?
This one from outside. Great strike from Mitch Brown, and big smiles at last for the Bombers. 6.5 minutes remaining now. Indecision. All over his face. Sets it up. Plenty going on. There's four Fremantle players to fly. Mitch Brown, Ryan, waded through the traffic. Thump goes the Wilson kick. 2-1-on-1. Goddard outpointed McCarthy. Myers against all the odds. The left footer from the corner. Oh, he's got there. The front of Myers to kick that. Yeah, they missed Big Sandy, haven't they? Could have made a world of difference, obviously. No fight, but the Bombers themselves had a substantial injury list to deal with through the year. Here's Heppel. Little push off. It's a good play. Bell Chambers to Zaharakis. Very influential.
Great kick.
Through the first part of this game. Brown eyeing off either Langford or another teammate ducking into the danger area. Devin Smith.
10 possessions, 3 goals. Not a lot of the ball, but made some good decisions as well.
Devin Smith. Essendon is still in the fight in season 2018.
And what he can do for the Dockers.
Yeah, they've really needed him today, and he just hasn't delivered. Probably the most experienced forward. I know they've sent Michael Johnson up there, who's played the majority of his career down back, and he's looked the most likely to deliver up forward. So an important game where they needed him to stand up, and you're right, just no continuity or consistency in his performance. And at this stage of his career, he's experienced enough now to be able to deliver on a consistent basis.
Mitch Brown screaming for the ball.
He'll still end up with it.
But instead, it's short to Fantasia, who'll be looking for his fifth. Don't the Bomber fans love him? He's kicked a bag of five twice before, and he's done it again.
He's got genuine class about him. Genuine class.
Four against the Roos a couple of weeks ago. Five times four more goals.
It's not little man, is it?
Smith, Saad or Stringer?
Smith. Clearly.
And have absolutely dominated in a number of categories, but it's taken to very late in this game for Essendon to keep their finals hopes alive. With a 5-goal victory, 13-21-99 to 11-4-70.